141 pounds, the living legend, Bruno Sammartino.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to Little Bob Soon here at ringside with his lordship, Alfred Hayes, in the Boston Garden. The Intercontinental Championship belt on the line, as down to the ring comes the living legend, Bruno Sammartino. And look at this, Savage, a little reluctant about letting the guy inside the ring. Elizabeth is still in there, and Sammartino is hot.
He is, and Sammartino obviously poses the biggest threat to the reign of the Intercontinental Champion.
Hiding behind Elizabeth, give me a break. Look at that despicable display. What is that? That he spat at it. Referee's got to get Elizabeth out of there. Oh, Sammartino nails it from behind, and we're underway. Sammartino going to work. Savage trying to sneak out of there, but he's caught by the former champion. He said that Sammartino was an old washed-up has-been, Alfred.
I think he's finding out that is not the fact. That is not the case at all.
Looking for somewhere to hide, and of course, Sammartino preventing him from getting outside the ring. It's been all Sammartino since the bell rang.
And Sammartino is determined not to be denied. He has taken this attack right to Savage. He hasn't given him one instant to breathe, let alone to react.
This capacity crowd chanting Bruno as they've done for so many years here in the Boston Garden. And he is in tremendous condition.
He really is. This is his old stomping grounds. And this is where Bruno is best, right here in the Garden.
He's got Savage in a whole lot of trouble right off the bat. I've ever seen the champion look.
I've never seen him look this bad before.
He's outside.
I would say his title is in definite jeopardy here.
Oh, look at that.
He's trying to
look at the
right
in front of him again. Bruno doesn't know what to do. I don't blame him. Oh, look at that. Sammartino turned around and tried to get back into the ring and was clobbered by the champion from the outside. Rammed it. Inside. Sammartino, the former champion, out on the deck, hurt.
Well, you know, Gorilla, they all say that Elizabeth's an unwilling partner in this, and that Savage uses her, but I think it's a conspiracy between the two of them, myself.
Could possibly be that, in fact.
I don't think they gamble at all on the fact that the other wrestler won't hit them. I think they just go in there knowing that he won't. And that really is not right, not at all. And now look what's happened to Bruno down there.
Sammartino once again, ran face first right into the steel railing. Onto the steps here. Oh. As Savage continues the punishment. Look out. Bombs away. Oh, right on the back of the neck of Bruno.
And that's how he's beaten practically every one of his opponents. He knocks them silly on the outside, throws them back in, and then pins them with ease. And this is what he's going to do again.
Savage wasting a whole lot of time here.
And Elizabeth has done the damage, and he's told her to go back to the dressing room, and she's gone. And now look at Savage.
Elizabeth has been ushered out of here by the security, and now the Macho Man out, going to the top once again.
But look at Bruno, he's coming to his feet.
Oh.
But he got caught again. I thought Bruno might just make that.
Sammartino with a desperation move sticks a finger right in the eye of the champion. Boy, this has been a war since the bell rang.
Bruno beginning to recover. from that savage attack that was launched against him outside the ring. And Bruno in the confines of the ring is extremely dangerous and very, very capable. Once again, it looks as if Savage is in trouble.
And now it's Bruno taking the play away from the champion.
Cracking
the old San Martino that everybody knows.
San Martino's going to give it to him now.
The Boston Gardens is going bananas. As the living legend continues to apply.
Big tackle coming. Boot right to the midriff for Savage. How much more punishment can Savage take? We know Bruno took a lot and weathered it. In fact, Bruno wasting just a little time. But I think he knows where he's got his man, and now he's making him suffer.
San Martino earlier on stated that he did not want any part of the Intercontinental title. He just wanted to get his hands on this guy and pay back for some of the derogatory remarks that Savage made about the living legend Bruno Sammartino, and he is in fact doing that.
He is. He's certainly not washed up by any means. Bruno Sammartino looking every bit as good as he did just a few years ago.
Champ caught it with a well-placed boot as Sammartino was looking for the backdrop. Dropped his head down momentarily. Wow. They both hit head-to-head, and the champion is out on the floor. Boy, they've spent a lot of time outside the ring in this one.
They really have.
Savage dragging
him out.
Dragging Sammartino out with him as they go to work.
And there's no doubt about it, Savage. There's always the governor outside the ring, but Bruno seems to have turned the tables on him.
Referee laying the count as the action going on right here in our side of the ring. Sammartino, here's the count. Look out. A chair right into the back of Sammartino. And Savage dives in under the rope, and there's the bell.
Referee rang for that bell. Savage thinks he's the winner. I believe indeed he is.
Savage maybe made it back in before the 10 count. Let's get the official decision.
The winner
is coming in from behind.
Oh,
a big boot to Savage.
Sammartino.
As you said,
from the back, but Bruno was counted out.
Bruno doesn't care.
Look at the bear hug.
Maybe inverted atomic drop.
Sammartino slapping on a bear hug. Referee trying to break it. He'll never be able to pull those arms apart.
No, those powerful arms around Savage. Look at Savage.
Two other referees coming down the ring.
Two more referees in the ring.
And
they won't break that.
Hugs.
They're not going to break that.
And still not successful.
That is a Superman in there.
Sammartino squeezing for all he's worth. And the champion is down.
The champion's legs just buckled. There's no more breath in his body. They better get somebody in to pull Sammartino off.
Sammartino still holding on to that bear hug. And the champion screaming.
Sammartino could injure him severely
here.
They
some additional help.
They better try and get him up, whatever they do.
It's Rotundo, Spivey, Tama, Central Kushner. Scotty McGee, they're trying to get Sammartino off him.
They can't break those powerful arms. And Savage must be in dire trouble.
And the bear hug finally broken loose. And Savage cannot hardly breathe.
He's moving 5-6 wrestlers. He carried them all on his shoulders over there just to get at Savage.
Sammartino still struggling to get at Savage, but boy, did he do some damage to the Intercontinental Heavyweight Champion. Took 6 of them to pull him off of the Macho Man Randy Savage. Look at Sammartino. He still wants a piece of him. And this capacity crowd is on its feet. They like what they've seen here, regardless of the outcome of this match.
Bruno was like a Superman there tonight.
Just
they're
on their feet. 18,000 plus.
You're right, Bruno. He didn't care about the title. He wanted a piece of Savage.
Let's get the official word.
The winner of the match by a count out, Randy the Macho Man Savage.
Won the battle, but he certainly lost the war, Alfred. Let's go back for some of the earlier action here in the Boston Garden as Sammartino comes back from outside.
After being counted out,
the ball had already run, and wow, look at that.
Just a tremendous right foot to the back of Savage, and from here on in, Savage couldn't do a thing. Watch these massive arms clamp themselves around Savage.
Slapped the barrel hook on and refused to turn it loose, but the Macho Man went on to victory. We haven't